Michael, the government of today is a state of corruption. The church of today is a state of corruption. The nation of today is a state of corruption. The state of humiliation. People in the world are suffering the humiliation. Humiliation of losing their life. Humiliation of losing their family. Humiliation of losing their money. Humiliation of losing their wives and their children. Humiliation of losing their life because of the evil presenter, governors, and senators. The members of church suffer humiliation. The people of the land suffered humiliation. The members of church suffer humiliation because they have lost their living God in their life. Because they have lost their living God in their life. They have lost their money, they have lost their business, they have lost their work, they have lost their church because of the evil pastors. What a futile blessed we have today. What a ritual blessed we have today. What a magician blessed we have today. What a bias church we have today. What a bias blessed we have today. What a hustler evil people we have today. It is appalling. It is appalling. So bad, very, very bad for your country, very, very bad for your city, very, very bad for your community, for your village. You must repent and change your way. Jesus is coming very soon. The coming of Son of Man is at hand. The word of God in the book of Amos, chapter 2, verse 6 says, "Thus said the Lord, for three transgression of Israel, for I will not rebuke its punishment, because they sell the righteous for money. Because they sell the righteous for money. And the need for a pair of sandals. They sell the need. The person sell the righteous for the money. The person sell his faithfulness for the money. The governor sells his righteous for the money. The governor sell his faithfulness, his truth for the money. The governor sell the righteous for the money. The blessed sell the righteous for the money. The word of God said the governors and senators sell the righteous for the money. They sell their faithfulness. They sell the truth for money. And the need for a pair of sandals. They sell the needs for the pair of sandals. Oh my God. Amos chapter 5 verse 11 said, therefore, because you impose heavy land on the poor president and a sad tribute of gain from them, through you have built horses of well heavy stone, horses of heavy stone, yet you will not live in them. Yet you will not live in them. You have planted pleasant vineyards, yet you will not drink the wine pleasant. You will never drink the wine, governor. You will never drink that. The word of God says, what? The evil of the pleasant is kept as a memento, memory in the world history. Nobody can remove it. Nobody can remove it. My brothers and sisters, share this message with everyone and win souls for the kingdom of God. Do not be afraid of the wicked and evil people. Do not be afraid of the wicked reverend fathers and the sisters. Do not be afraid of the evil pastor. Do not be afraid of the evil apostle. Do not be afraid of the evil bishop. Do not be afraid of the evil evangelist. Do not be afraid of the evil president and his cabinet. Do not be afraid of the evil governors and his cabinet. Do not be afraid of the evil lawmakers. Do not be afraid of the evil people. For the word of God in the book of Luke, chapter 12, verse 8 says, I tell you the truth, everyone who confess me before men, the Son of Man will also confess him before the angels of God. Isaiah 52 verse 7 says, how beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who proclaim liberty, who proclaim freedom, who bring good things, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God rejoices. Romans chapter 10 verse 15 says, and how can they preach unless they are saved? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. People will never hear this message unless you share this message with them. Who knows? Maybe God can use you to convert many souls to the kingdom of God. The more you share this message, the more God blessing flow into your life, into your house, into your family, into your shop, into your business, into your office. God bless anyone who share this message with people. God bless you, and the peace of God be upon you. God bless you once again.